Jasoda Nandana Brajajana Ranjana Jasoda Nandana Brajajana Ranjana Jamuna Tira Vanachari Jamuna Tira Vanachari Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Jaya Radha Madha, Jaya Radha Madha, Jaya Radha Madha, Jaya Radha Madha. Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai, Jaya Gauranitai. Jaya Jaya Prabhupada, 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 Prabhupada.
Radha Madhava Ju ki, Sri Prabhupada ki jai. Shama Beta Bhaktavrinda ki jai, Shri Gopal Bhatta Goswami ki jai, Nitai Go Pre Manandi, Hari Hari Bol. So we are reading from the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 8, Chapter 22, text number 28. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Esha Dhanava Daityanam. Agrani Kirti Vardhanaha. Ajishid no jayam mayam. Shitanapi namuyate. Eshadanava daityanam. Agrani kirti vardhanaha. Ajishid ajam mayam. Shitanapi namuyate. Eshadanava daityanam. Agrani kirti vardhanaha. Ajashit ajayam mayam. Shitanapi namuyati. Eshadanava daityanam. Agrani kirti vardhana. Ajasira jayam mayam. Yadi abhimuyate. Eshadaita dhanmanam. Satanyava Daityanam Agrakiti Vardhanaha Hajasirajam Mayam Shiranapi Namuyati. Satanyava Daityanam Agrahi kirti vardhanaha. Ajayishit ajayam mayam. Siranapi namuyate. He shatanana dutaityanam. Agrani kirti vardhanam. Ajasit ajayam mayam. Sitamapi namuyate. Eshadanava daityanam. Agrini kirti vardhana. Ajasit ajayam mayam. Chitamapi namuyate. Esha, this Bali Maharaj, Danava Daityanam, among the demons and unbelievers, Agrani, the foremost devotee, Kirti Varadanaha, the most famous. Ajayasid has already surpassed Ajayam, the insurmountable. Mayam, material energy. Shidan, being bereft of all material opulences. Oppi, although, na, not. Muyati, is bewildered. Translation in purple by His Divine Grace, the boy Charanaravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Bali Maharaj has become the most famous among the demons and non-believers. For in spite of his being bereft of all material opulences, he is fixed in his devotional service. Please repeat. Bali Maharaj has become the most famous among the demons and non-believers. For in spite of being bereft of all material opulences, he is fixed in his devotional service. In this verse, the words Sitanam Oppina Muyati are very important. A devotee is sometimes put adversity is put into adversity while executing devotional service. In adversity, everyone laments and becomes aggrieved. But by the grace of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, a devotee, even in the worst condition, can understand that he is going through a severe examination by the Personality of Godhead. Bali Maharaj passed all such examinations, as explained in the following verses. Om Agyanti Midandasya Jannan Janan Shalakeva Takshurun Militandina Tasmai Shri Guruna Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Garadha Shri Vashari Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hari 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 Ramo Hari Ramo Rama Rama Hari 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 Krishna. So today is also the disappearance day of Gopal Bhatta Goswami. So we can speak a little bit about Gopal Bhatta. In the Gaura Ganadesha Dipika, it is said that formerly Gopal Bhatta Goswami was, in Krishna Lili, he was an Anga Manjari. Radharani's younger sister. And others also say that he was an incarnation of Guna Manjari. So both are there. The Radharaman temple, which Gopal Bhatta was serving Radharamanji there. I spoke to Vishwamba Goswami. He was the, before Padmanabha Goswami Zena. Before that was Vishwamba Goswami, he's a friend of Prabhupada's. And Prabhupada told him we should learn puja from him, from Radharaman, which we did. And he told me, he said that when we're going to serve Radharaman in the deity room, we go in as the assistants of Guna Manjari. I said, this is your mood of going in. He said, yeah, more than mood. The mood is there. Also dress, color, service. That also we meditate on. The Raghunuga Sadhana Bhakti. So anyway, it appears that they are worshipping. He said we're going as assistants of Guna Manjari, so they're accepting at least Guna Manjari as the incarnation of Gopal Bhatta Goswami, who appeared to assist the Lord in his pastimes. And he appeared in Sri Rangam, yeah. Gopal Bhatta, so long far away from Mahaprabhu in Bengal, but he was a contemporary. He was born so far away. But still, he had a benediction by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Mahaprabhu would actually reveal to him the different pastimes. The different pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his Navadvipa pastimes, and Mahaprabhu would come and give him visions. So he was a special devotee, born in South India, so he could carry the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Gopal Bhatta saw the pastime, it was revealed to him that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was taking sannyas. But Gopal Bhatta, he didn't like that. He was to see Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and taking his sannyas. Gopal Bhatta Goswami is a member of the Vrindavan entourage of Radha Krishna and all their devotees. He's one of those members. So then we see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is Radha Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Radha Krishna Nayanya. The Vrindavan entourage, they don't like to see Krishna. They realize it's the same Krishna, but they don't like to see Krishna as a sannyasi. Why Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Supreme Enjoyer, should shave his hair, carry a water pot, live austerely? He didn't like that. Maybe also Krishna does Kaviraj. Not Krishna. Maybe in Chaitanya Bhagavad. Vrindavan Leela Vyas, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Who wrote Chaitanya Bhagavad? Vrindavanadas. Okay, Vrindavanadas. Vrindavanadas. I don't accept Mahaprabhu took sannyas. I don't accept. Even though he did, didn't he? He left Navadvipa and he went to Puri. But the devotees have that sentiment. The Navadvipa mood, that sentiment. They don't like to worship Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as a sannyasi. That's why on the altar we dress Gauranga up in his Navadvipa pastimes, Navadvipa Leela, in the Grihastha Ashram. So where he has that beautiful flowing hair in his fold, dhoti folded three times, always engaged in Sankirtan, Prem Sankirtan with all the devotees. So they don't like to think that their Krishna should become a renunciant. Beggar. Sannyasi means he has to go around begging. So this, thinking of this very austere, the austerities that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has to go through as a sannyasi, Gopal Bhatta, he was crying alone, thinking about that. Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared to him and he showed his Navadvipa pastimes. Gopal was very happy, but when he saw the beauty of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he fell on the floor, fainted. When he got up again, Lord Chaitanya was there, but again he was in the form of a sannyasi. But Gopal Bhatta was very happy to see the different manifestations of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Mahaprabhu said, you should go, he gave him some instruction, you should go to Vrindavan, where he went, spent most of his life in Vrindavan with the other Goswamis, and you should make disciples. And your disciples in turn will make other disciples, like this little Mahaprabhu's message will spread all over the world. So this is also, this mood is expressed in the Navadvipa Avataranga of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, after he took sannyas, went to Puri. When he came back, he was going to Advaita Acharya's house, He stopped in Navadvipa at Vidyaspati's house, Vida Vidyaspati, in Vidyanaga, the other side of the Ganga and up. And everybody understood. Now Mahaprabhu came back, he's come back to Navadvipa. Mahaprabhu's back, he's in Navadvipa again, he's back, back. Everybody just flocked towards Vidyaspati's house. And there Mahaprabhu, he was on the rooftop giving us this golden divine darshan. Everyone, they saw it. Oh, Mahaprabhu is back again. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, in a similar mood, that the gopis have for Krishna, especially at Kuruketra, when they were expressing that you are our Krishna, you are our lovable object. But here at Kuruketra, you're dressed as a king. There's all armor is. You've got chariots and horses and thousands of soldiers, 16,000 queens. You're the same Krishna we've always loved, but here we like to see you in Vrindavan. You please come back to Vrindavan. This is Rath Yatra. We're pulling the Rath. Vrindavan Jabu, Vrindavan Jabu. This is the meaning of Rath Yatras. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught us. We're pulling Krishna back to Vrindavan. So the gopis were having this mood. You're the same Krishna, but it's the different dress and different environment. We want to take you. So now you're dressed as a sannyasi. We don't like to see this. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was expressing. We want to see you back at Sribal Sangam on the bank of the Ganga, performing Hari Nama Prema Samkirtans. We're there where you were there with your beautiful golden dhoti and long hair and performing all these wonderful. You're the same Lord. I know you're the same Lord, but this is our heart's desire. We don't want this. Vrindavan is Krishna's only pleasure. That's why he never leaves Vrindavan. And if he leaves Vrindavan, it's only for the pleasure of his devotees. It's not for his pleasure. These different incarnations of the Lord, they're all for the pleasure of his devotees. Krishna has no need for any expansions. He's perfectly satisfied in Vrindavan. Everything he wants. But because his devotees like to serve him sometimes as a king, so then, okay, I'll become Lord Ramachandra. You can, Sita will be, Radharani will become Sita, and Balaram will become Lakshman. But these pastimes are for the pastimes of my pleasure of my devotees. They are not my pleasure. My pleasure is here in Vrindavan. So Mahaprabhu was showing all this at the Rath Yatra festival when he's dancing and he's had a little leela going with Jagannath and he was expressing one thing and the cart would stop and not go. But if we hadn't have had that Rath Yatra and heard Mahaprabhu and you know the way that Mahaprabhu explained it, it would be difficult to understand this original personality of Godhead Krishna. Who is very difficult to understand. But Mahaprabhu has revealed that who that original person, the Vrindavan Krishna, Braj Krishna. And therefore he comes only once in a day of Brahma, on the 28th millennium, when the original personality of Godhead comes, then Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes and follows him. The original personality of Godhead Krishna, he performs his Braja pastimes of sweetness, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes and performs his pastimes of giving that sweetness. Krishna is absorbed in sweetness of his own pastimes in Vrindavan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu follows, he gives that sweetness. Therefore, Mahabhananaya, Krishna Prema, he's giving that Braja Prema, which is very, very rarely available, only once in a day of Brahma. That Krishna we would not know about if it wasn't for Mahaprabhu, who is explaining like that. But you won't find this through the Shastras. Anyway, so Gopal Bhatta Goswami, his father was Venkatapat. He lived in Sri Rangam. And during the Chaturmasya, he requested Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you can stay here. He had a room. If you go there, you can see that room. It's not far from Venkatapat's house. It's a very small room. Some Jagannath deities in there. And Mahaprabhu stayed there for the rainy season, the 4 months. And he became very friendly with Venkatapat and Gopala Bhatta, his son. And Mahaprabhu, he detected a little bit of pride was there in Venkatapat. Pride. Krishna likes to destroy the pride of his devotee. This Bali Maharaj also, this story of Bali Maharaj we've been reading about. So many aspects, but one of them was to destroy the pride of the devotee. Krishna doesn't like his devotees to be proud. So Venkata, he was worshipping Lakshmi Narayan. These were his worshipful deities. And Lakshmi Narayan is all the incarnations come from Lakshmi Narayan. And Krishna is also an incarnation of Narayan. So therefore I'm worshipping the supreme form, Lakshmi Narayan. They're the supreme form of Godhead. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu detected that. So he said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said in comparison, you know, Lakshmi Narayan there, they're the supreme personality of God. There's no one has equaled them. You are worshipping them. But my Krishna, on the other hand, he hasn't got any opulences. Got some gunja berries and some decorated with peacock feathers. And there's some forest flowers, make some wild forest flower garlands. He doesn't have any opulences. But tell me one thing, why Lakshmi Devi, she went to Vrindavan to perform austerity so she could join in the Ras dance. So how is it that she couldn't get in? He said, that's okay, Radha Krishna and Lakshmi, they're the same personalities. They're not different personalities. He said, yeah, I know that, but why she couldn't get in the Ras arena? Why she's doing austerities and meditation to get in the Ras arena? So Venkatapat said, I can't understand these things. Only you can understand. You're the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You please tell me. So Mahaprabhu explained that in that the Lakshmi Narayan, they're the Supreme God and Goddess of the world. Everybody knows that Narayan is the Supreme God. And Venkatapati, he was thinking that Lord Narayan is Ajja, means he is unborn. Whereas other forms like Krishna and Rama, they take birth in this world. We see them, they're little babies and they're growing up in it. But my Narayana Lord, he doesn't take birth, he's Ajja, so he must be the God, he must be the Supreme Personality of Godhead. And Krishna is an incarnation of my Lord, Narayana. So anyway, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, then he revealed to him the sweetness of Krishna's pastimes, that Mahaprabhu said even the Shrutidharas, the sages, these are persons who attain forms to serve Krishna in Vrindavan, the Shrutidharas, They wanted to witness his conjugal pastimes of Radha and Krishna. So they did austerities, not severe austerities, but they the process they adopted was that of the gopis, which is to always remember Krishna, always remember Krishna at every moment. Krishna is their life and soul. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said there is no means of self-realization. A noble error would be a means of self-realization superior to that was adopted by the gopis of Vrindavan. They had surrendered everything to Krishna. They knew nothing but Krishna. This was their attitude. But Lakshmiji, she didn't follow in the footsteps of the gopis. The Srutidharas did, and they attained gopi bodies. They could enter pastimes of Krishna. But Lakshmiji, she was attached to her meditation on opulence, and she was meditating. She found herself repeatedly back with Lord Narayan. If you're worshipping one particular, that you're going to get that particular result. If you worship Krishna in Braja, you're going to get that. If she was worshipping Krishna in opulence, so she gets a different result. She didn't get Braja, she got Narayan. She tried to get Krishna, but she couldn't get him. Because she was attached to the opulence of being the goddess of fortune, Lakshmi. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, very jokingly, was defeated by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So that's the process, following in the footsteps of the gopis. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was instructed us, gopi pariyo kamala, das, anudas. We should consider ourselves to be servant of the servant, of the master of the gopis. Gopinat. Therefore, I wish the deva is Gopinat. So, Gopavata, we know he was worshipping Radharamanji. Radharamanji ki jay. Everybody loves Radharaman. Most perfect form of the Lord, self-manifested deity. So the history, after the Battle of Kurukshetra, King Parikshit was dividing his kingdom to different kings, favorable kings who had helped him in the battle. And Brajanab was the great grandson of Lord Krishna. He chose when Parikshit Maharaj requested that he take some land for kingdom. He said, "I want the tract of land known as Mathura, Vrindavan." So Parikshit Maharaj awarded him that. So he went to Vrindavan with his family guru. His name? Sandila Muni. And he was in ecstasy to be in Vrindavan. But after some time he said, it's nice to be here, but if there was something a little bit more positive, because all the pastimes of Krishna had been practically lost by then. Something a bit more positive, like some deities and things like that, it'll be a bit more positive. We'll be able to relate to Krishna's pastimes here in Vrindavan if we have deities. So Brajanab, he made a deity. They called Uddhava and Uttara. And these were the only two persons living at that time who had personally seen Krishna. Everyone else had dead, left their bodies. So they invited, Brajanab invited Parikshit and, Uddhava and Uttara, and they examined the deity. And they said, feet are very, very beautiful, like Krishna's. But the rest, not so much like. So then they made another deity. So again, they came and examined and said, face is very beautiful, like Krishna. But the rest is not exactly. So he made another deity. And they said, yeah, the chest is very, gets Krishna with his torso. But the rest, not exactly. So that is those deities become Madan Mohan, Govinda and Gopinath. Then there was an oracle in the sky, sound vibration, Akashvani. You can't just make a deity and expect that you can make Krishna just by making a deity. If the Lord wants to appear, he will appear by his own sweet will. Not that you can manufacture Krishna. But when the time is right, he will manifest. So then, 4,500 years later, then we had the appearance of Radharamanji. And Radharaman's form, he had the feet of Madan Mohan, he had the face of Govinda, and he has the chest of Gopinathji. So he was a perfect incarnation. He embodied all the three deities. So he manifested himself from a Shalagram Shila. Gopal Bhatta was at the Nepal Gandaki River where the Shalagramas come from. It said that he put his lotus in and the 12 Shalagrams appeared in his lotus. He put them back in the river. Again, he got some more water. Again, the 12 Shalagrams were there. So he thought that Krishna, maybe he wants to accept some worship. So he brought back these 11 Shalagrams and was worshipping them. And one day one rich merchant came and he was giving clothing for the deities and ornaments and things like that. And Govinda with Madan Mohan was there. And Gopal Bhatta said, I don't have a nice, beautiful form. Rupa and Sanatan, and they've got beautiful deities. You can see the form. They dress them every day. They can offer ornaments. But I've just got little stones to worship. And so I would like to have a form to worship. And anyway, I can't. I got this merchant sent all this jewelry and everything. I can't offer it, all these clothes. It happened to be Nrisingha Chaturdashi day. So he was remembering also how Lord appeared from a stone. Lord Nrisingha had appeared from a stone pillar. So he's remembering the past and how the Lord appeared from the stone. So then when he woke up in the morning, one Shalagram Shila, whose name is Damodara, it had become transformed into Radharamanji. Stone became Krishna. So he's very happy. Oh, look, form of the Lord. If you see on the back of the Radharamanji, if you're fortunate enough to get close, you see on the back side there's a little markings of a chakra with a still there from the from the Damodara Shalagram. So yeah, Shalagram is Krishna. Generally, they worship according to the Vedic literature. Generally, they worship the Shalagram Shila as the Narayan. And they chant the Purusha Shukta mantra and everything. But here we saw the Shalagram became Krishna. In Mayapur also, we have the Shaligram was introduced by Srila Prabhupada. It was the first ISKCON temple in the world to worship Shaligram Srila. Prabhupada told the managers, you should institute the Shaligram worship. So we got one Shaligram. Jayapataka Maharaj got one, and we showed to Prabhupada, and Prabhupada did a little puja and everything in his room. He was on the altar. We put him on the altar and we started worshiping, but nobody knew what Shaligram was, because there was mostly Western disciples in those days. There wasn't many Indian devotees, and so the Western devotee hadn't a clue what Shaligram Srila was. We never heard of it before. And they were coming and they said, what is it? Shaligram. Is it Jagannath? I said, I don't know. he's black and he's got white eyes. But, and a few people there, Gopal Krishna, he was there. But he knew. He said, it's just Narayana Srila or Krishna Srila. Another one is just Shaligrama Srila. I was completely bewildered. So I went up to Srila Prabhupada's room and I asked him, Srila Prabhupada, some say that this Shaligram is Krishna, and some say he is Narayana. And Prabhupada looked at me and he said, forget some say. Very heavy. I didn't pursue it anymore because of the tone. I bowed my way out. And 2 days later he sent a message. He said, tell Pujari he should offer a bumsi to Shaligram. Indicating that we should worship as Krishna. So a very famous deity. Some years ago, they made a Radharani for Radharamanji. They thought we'd get Radharani and we'll worship with, because there was no Radha, and Krishna's here in Vrindavan. So they made a brass deity of Srimati Radharani, and so they started the worship there. And on the first night or the next morning, when they woke up, there's no Radharani, wasn't there on the altar. It was gone. And then sometime later they found out she was in some Devi temple in between Vrindavan and Kadeli somewhere. There's one Devi temple. Radharani was there. Radharamani manifested himself. I guess if he wants Radharani, she'll manifest himself. So we will wait for Radharani to come. instead of trying to install her ourselves. So anyway, now they have a they have a Varshana Shila is there. Gold plated. And it has Radharani's mantra on it. That's what's there. And you've seen that he put a little dress and a little crown there. But actually that's what's there. There's no deity there. It's just a Vaishana Srila. Radharamanju ki jai. Okay, Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. So... 22. Bali Maharaj has become the most famous amongst the demons and non-believers, for in spite of his being bereft of material opulence, he is fixed in his devotional service. So here, we're getting many angles of visions of the state of consciousness of Bali Maharaj. It appears he's in Maya, he's not in Maya. So Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur has given us another angle of vision. So he's posing the question, what type of mercy of yours did Bali Maharaj, who was your devotee, what type of mercy did he receive when you took away all of his wealth and everything? And the Lord says, he conquered Maya. He had conquered Maya. That's greater than all the wealth you can possess, right? If you can conquer Maya. So he said he's conquered Maya. He said, I don't say he will conquer or he is conquering. He has already conquered. He said, look, Bali Maharaj has become the most famous among demons and non-believers. Bali Maharaj has become most famous. It means he was already a devotee, self-realized devotee. Now that's why he's these different things that are coming up, he will be disrespected. They're using these types of words. arrogance. These terms have been used sometimes in the relationship with his guru, and but all these are qualifications of Maya, arrogance and disrespect. These are Maya's qualities, but he's not influenced. So where is the question of actually he's being distressed or anything like that? Here it says, in the purport, in adversity, everybody laments, becomes aggrieved. So everybody is lamenting and becoming aggrieved when they're put into adversity as a natural reaction. But Bali Maharaj, he didn't. He wasn't aggrieved. These are the qualities of Maya. Grieving over things is a sutra, lamenting. These are sutra's qualities, the productions of Maya. So he was out of Maya. So where is the question that these qualities were ever suitable to apply to Bali Maharaj? He had the greatest treasure. He was fixed in his devotional service. He wasn't fixed in Maya. So he wasn't actually influenced by all of these. You know, his wife said, you're in Maya, you think you've got something, but he wasn't in Maya. But it's recorded like he's in Maya, and Bali Raj is and Mahajana, and he's famous for that, for giving everything, but he didn't have anything. So there's so many different types, but the idea is that he was a pure devotee of the Lord. Before all this incident happened, he was a pure, that's the greatest thing. And he never stopped his service, even throughout this whole episode. So he was above Maya. Why he should be bewildered? So here in this, at the end of this purport, it says, in adversity, everyone laments and becomes grieved. But by the grace of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, a devotee, even in the worst condition, can understand that he is going through a severe examination by the Personality of Godhead. Severe examination. Most people will go through examination. In the Brahma Samhita, it also says, in the Indra Gopa verse, that the Lord, he purges out the roots, to the roots all of karma by the fire of ordeal. There is a fire of ordeal that one has to go through to purge out all of those last karmic seeds in the heart. Everybody goes through a fire of ordeal, most people. We see ourselves, people who have left their body here, this is a very traumatic time. It's a test. This is the fire of ordeal. It's burning away all of their... If there are any reactions left, there is burning all that. That's Krishna's... But go through this fire ordeal. For Srila Prabhupada, for example, he showed us. Of course, Prabhupada had all opulence. Krishna didn't take it away, Krishna gave. And Prabhupada said, if Krishna gives opulence, which has been the theme of this story, giving and taking away, if Krishna gives opulence, it's to understood that devotee is more advanced than the devotees he takes away from, because they know how to use opulence. They can be using Krishna service. So they're actually more advanced. So Prabhupada had that Krishna gave. 40 rupees, 40 crores he came back with. So he had that blessing from. But still also, as an acharya, Prabhupada was showing how to leave. But this fire ordeal. And Prabhupada voluntarily went through that fire. He stopped eating. Now the doctor said that he had no flesh on his body. So that means he... skin and everything, and the bones are all resting on the nerves. The nerves are resting on, there's no fat, there's no padding there. It's extremely painful. The whole body is extremely painful because the nerves are pressing on the bones and things like that. The doctor said no one could usually live under these circumstances, but Prabhupada was there. He was tolerating. One time he called out, "I cannot tolerate this anymore." I heard from someone. There's different opinions. Some people say, was he suffering? Or well, one understanding is that Prabhupada came down from the Uttamadhikara platform to the Madhyam to preach. And in the Madhyamadhikara, you deal with the material world. In the Uttamadhikara, you Hari Bol, Hari Krishna. Material world, you don't relate to the material world, you relate only to Krishna. But for preaching, then the Uttamadhikari comes down to the Madhyamadhikari for preaching. So, otherwise, how would he know how would he know the pains and pleasures of this world? He's above all that. So he chooses to come down as a Madhyamadhikari, and he deals with the material world. And he experiences the actions and reactions of the material world. Otherwise, where would there be compassion? If he was just Uttamadhikari, be compassionate. Why don't you be compassionate and preach to the souls? Everybody's a devotee. Everybody's in ecstasy. Look, look, look. That's all you see in Uttamadhikari. So, for preaching, Prabhupada took on his austerities and he showed us by his example as a acharya most people have got to go through this fire ordeal. Prabhupada showed us, very severe. It was a voluntary one he chose. Devotees not usually so bad, but there you see devotees are about to leave their body. It's a very kind of intense situation. What did Prabhupada say when he was in that condition? Don't think it will not happen to you. Everybody will have to experience it, some degree or less. Some devotees immediately go back to Godhead. One sannyasi in Mamgachi, he said, "I don't like to stay here anymore." Sandhyati was going on. He was old, so he was just sitting in front. He was seeing the Sandhyati at Mamgachi. The arti finished, and then his godbrother said, "Okay, the arti is finished now," but he wasn't there. He just left his body. So many examples how people just go straight back to God. They don't have to go through any hardships like that. But Krishna gives, he takes away. He's the omnipotent. We can't understand how the Lord works. He's different programs. Or our Jayapataka Swami Maharaj, Krishna takes away. Use of the hands, use of feet, liver, kidney. What is Jayapataka Maharaj doing? He's still continuing his service. 100% service. Whatever he's got left, whatever Krishna's taken, whatever is left, he's using in Krishna's service. He's 24 hours surrendered to Krishna. Whatever he takes, Krishna takes away. Whatever is left, he's using. It's like Prabhupada, he had a little bit of energy left in his tongue. He'd speak. Put the microphone there. Because I've got a little bit of energy, up to the last. And I can translate Srimad Bhagavatam. A little bit of energy. 100% surrender to Krishna. Whatever situation is there, that they can use, they will use in Krishna's service. I was going in the. I was talking to Jai Pratak Maharaj. He was leaving the temple. He was going to the lift to go up to his room. And he was saying something, but then, you know, it's difficult for him to move one step. If someone comes and they're asking something, he moves another step and someone else comes up. Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, Guru Maharaj. Everybody's coming all the time. So, anyway, we couldn't talk because so many people are coming and asking this, touching feet. And so he said, we go into the lift room and then they will close the doors and no one can come in. No one can come. So I go inside there and then he's coming. Last he comes in and he says, get away from the circus. He came in and he closed the doors. He said, oh, get away from the circus. Means he's seen the circus, it's a show, which actually it is. He was seeing like that. So that was his vision. How he is transcendental, transcendental to everything else, not mood. He's seeing everything as a get away from the circus. In fact, it is like this, the material world is a circus. But Jai Pratak Maharaj is going along with it. He's not stopping. Because he's seeing the Krishna conscious show. He's not seeing Maya's circus. He's seeing the Krishna conscious show. He's seeing like that. There's a song, ISKCON, must be an ISKCON devotee. Tell everybody what you know about Prabhupada's magic show. It's a magic show. You heard that? Nice. I like that. Prabhupada come, he created. Maya's got a magic show going on. We're all bewildered and attracted. Krishna comes, Prabhupada comes. He makes the show, Krishna conscious show. We don't have to listen to see Maya's show, we got our own. This was the magic of Prabhupada. So this is we're seeing by the Acharyas who Prabhupada, let me continue because I can translate Bhagavatam because it's my Guru Maharaj's instruction for me to translate. Right on his last. He just absorbed in doing his guru's seva. Completely 100% surrendered. Oh, so Krishna took away the clothes of the gopis. He took away. We're going to tell your Nanda Baba or King Kamsa about your behavior. But they never complained. Because they loved Krishna. Krishna himself took himself away from the rasa arena. But when that whole thing was over, the whole pastime of Krishna, Radha disappearing, Krishna again uniting. when it was all over at the end, the gopis say, they said, we don't exactly even know what happened last night, what took place last night, but whatever took place, we found that our love for Krishna has increased more and more. This was the result of it. So like this, all these tribulations and everything else that go on in the material world, either on an individual level or at the universal level like Bali Maharaj. For the devotees to Krishna, at the end of the day, we'll be able to appreciate how love for Krishna has increased more and more and more. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Shri Prabhupada ki jai, Samaveda Bhaktabinda ki jai, Nitai Gopi Manandi. Thank you.